Enrico Sini, who wants to talk about how to build your own modern app installer.
Thank you.
Just start.
Hi. I'm Enrico Sini. As some of you know, I have something to do with DevTech. And generally, I've been working trying to enhance package information and the user experience of looking for packages and so on. I've always had this idea that Debian is huge, right? There's loads of packages, which is a problem because it's hard to find things. So some people started to say Debian shouldn't grow too much because otherwise it becomes a mess. And I started to say, let's find ways to handle the mess. And so DevTex came out and a few other things that I'm going to show you. If you want, I put the notes of the talk in Gobi. I hope it's big enough. I've improvised this slide. So if you want to, during the talk, I'll try to give as many ideas as possible and point to technologies and so on. So if you want to enhance the notes or just follow them or read them in 5 minutes and leave and find another talk, they're there and use them as you please. And feel free to enhance them. Sorry. I hit it by mistake. What is in an ideal application installer? Voices. I guess you can say it without the microphone, and I'll repeat it. Brainstorming session. What do you see in an ideal application installer, like package manager sort of thing? It must install what I need. It must know what I need. Right. That'd be good. We'll get there. Soon. Within the last couple of hours. More?
So can we have a visual representation of the application of what to install? Because many of the descriptions of many of our games sound very good.
So it should give a visual, I repeat it because if you run around with microphone and a brainstorm is a mess. It should give a visual like screenshots or preview of the application because sometimes, like in case of games, the description doesn't tell that much. Indeed? Yeah? It should keep track of installed version and? Okay. So it should let me know of important changes in my packages and allow me to keep my system up to date, basically, with the most critical, so I'm aware of the most critical things about the system.
If I search for burning DVD, it should just find the right application.
Right. If I search for burn DVD, it should just find the right application. Exactly. Okay, so a few ideas. Yeah, you are imaginative, not ambitious enough. So add a few more, so it should, you know, search, browse, explore, install, remove, the usual thing. It should have all sorts of information, description, tags, screenshots, even more information than that. We start to be used to social information, like rating, comments, and package recommendations. There could be different installers for different needs. Not necessarily if you want to, so, I mean, there's a kind of user that would like just to install graphical application and there's like the software developer that would like to look for libraries available for a specific programming language. Not necessarily the same interface will work for both. You don't have screenshots of libraries, although you could show like URLs to APIs. And at the same time, you don't want to clutter something about graphical information with information about development libraries. So it's very exciting. You know, when I said lots more, we're going to see some more later of information you can have. It is exciting because it's very easy to access unthinkable amounts of cool information. The only thing that we need is interfaces. We have a lot of back-end code that is ready and usable. And it's having interfaces, it's having all these installers that doesn't have much work yet. Possibly because All the work that's been done so far is by plumbers, like me. You know, like the Git world has been talking a lot in terms of plumbing and porcelain, and where the plumbing is like the pipes, and the porcelain is the user interface. And loads of people have done plumbing, experimenting with ways to index and deal with all sorts of information. But these people are not the best people to build a proper user interface. So we need the second step. We need to bring in people who haven't done the plumbing, but they can build on it and build something cool and useful. So some example mock-ups of random ideas that I think are slightly missing and that can be very easy to build nowadays. So you can have something inspired by a search engine with a search box, and you type whatever you want and you get a list of what you need. And it can even you can do something like a preview that if you don't type anything, the software will suggest something that you may need. This can be done. Hopefully. Now we'll ask Tassia about the second step, but that will come, you know, wait an hour, she'll tell you about it. Or you can do a similar interface for uninstalling packages. Your system's full of rubbish, or you know, you fill up the disk, the USR or something, and you'd like to get rid of packages. And you can do the same, look for search only among the installed packages. And if you don't type anything, it will show those packages that you are not using. You know, the first package you see is the one that you use more time, the most time ago. That is also very easy to do. Or you can make something like two cows, Android, app installers, something like this, with, you know, screenshots, comment, again, searchy thingy, ratings. I made it with the swirls. Cows would work very nicely in Debian, but they've been used already. So that is easy. Or you can make something like online shopping sites, kind of Amazon things, with then you type something and you get categories on the left. I guess you're used to this kind of interface. And screenshots as a preview and descriptions if you want. Yeah, this is a mock-up that already works. And I published the code on my blog and not many people noticed it. But just to say, that can be done. Just clean it, you know. You just need to show tag descriptions instead of ugly tag names. And maybe, you know, put the proper description here. And you have it. Just need somebody to do it and deploy it somewhere. Or you can have a browser for the packages that are already installed, and which will, you know, show what's on your what's in your system, and you can sort by show first the last packages you have installed, so you can like install things and then have a look. What did I install? Let's try them. Or show first the packages you use the most, and you can have links to man page documentation in user share doc, something to launch all the binaries provided by, and even maybe something to contribute rating and comments to Debian, so it can be shown in application installers. That'd be nice to have, right? We don't have it. We don't have anything to browse the power of an installed Debian system. Except like for the GNOME or KDE menu, which is just a huge menu of things. So why not? In order to do all that, we have several building blocks we can use, and I'm going to show them like apt-get Appian index, which is this backend code I've done for all sort of cool and smart package. For handling all sort of package information and very fast. I forgot to do this first, I apologize. No. Black on white, okay. So Apptix Appian Index is likely to be already in your system because it's used by Software Center, a few other things. So you may already have Axie Cache. Okay, the font is big, it doesn't show much. But for example, you can do, if you need to look for like something to program in C, you can do apt-cache search C, and it's a bad idea. However, you can do axie-cache search C, and you likely get, it knows that it's about C. You know, you get C, GCC and so on. Same about GNU-R and other similar things that we have that have one-letter names. So this one indexes words. And interestingly, it will give you suggestions for other terms you may want to look for, or tags, like depth-text tags, that are related to what you were looking for. And it can even give you spelling suggestion, like, did you mean gedit? It's there in your system today. It's even the first command line application that allows you to find something before you run it. So if you do apt-cache search tab, you get a list of tags you may be interested in. Say, I want a program. So program. And then say, what for? Let's say for image. And so you get basically context sensitive tab completion. And by the time you finish the command line, you know what you want. And at the beginning, you didn't. There you go. Programs to do something with images, and how about raster images or utilities, and so on, and you get more. So that is Apptix Appian Index. In my blog, it's full of posts that teach you how to use it from code. The examples I post in my blog are in Python, but you access it using the Xappian libraries. Xappian is a search engine library. And the Xappian libraries have binding for any language except C and Lua. And so people still complain there's no bindings for Lua. I agree, it would be nice to have them, but maybe somebody's doing it. But they get bindings for Perl, Python, Ruby, PHP, if you want to do it online. And it's natively C++. And that's the first. Screenshots.debian.net, you know about it? Who knows? Who's never heard of screenshots.debian.net? Who's heard of screenshots.debian.net? Okay, great. Who has uploaded to screenshots.debian.net? Great. Cool thing of screenshots.debian.net, if you have HTTP and a package name, you have screenshots. It's, you know, any web page you make that displays packages, you can just put an image source equal screenshots.debian.net /something/package and it becomes a screenshot. So there's no excuse not to have screenshots in anything online. Because it's just, it's that easy. Where is it? Here? No. What? Okay, browse, and somewhere there should be documentation of the API, although it doesn't fit at the moment on the screen. About, maybe. There you go. How we can use the screenshots. And there you have it. As easy as that. screenshot.debian.net/package/thumbnail/screenshot and so on. With this, you can make a link to a page with information about the package. With this, you get a small screenshot. With this, you get the big screenshot. Any web page takes nothing. It's there. App install data. It's a package that contains desktop files and icons for every package in Debian. I do not have a W3AF installed in my system, but with app install data, I have the .desktop file and the icon, which means if I want to make an application installer, for every search result that has an icon, I can show it. And if it has a desktop file, I can show in the search results, I can show the menu location where it's going to be installed, and free desktop description and so on, because it's all there. And it's also interesting because besides the normal .desktop file information, they have extra bits, which is the package you need to install to get it, and popcorn rating, and this section. So that allows you to sort all applications in your result by popularity. And you can only just search the desktop file information, and you know you get the correspondence to packages. Software Center does that. Oops. What's that? Why do I press B and it becomes black? B black? Right. Distro match. I don't think many people know about it. Who knows about it? Oh, wow. Not bad. Usually it's only me knowing what I do. Great. Distro match is a new thing. It allows you to say, there's this package in Fedora. I can't find it in Debian. Is it in Debian, and what's its name? I'll give a demo. Again, it's still, no. Okay. So let's say Fedora RPM. There you go. In RPM in Fedora can correspond to those packages in other distributions. It knows about a lot of distributions. Basically, all the RPM ecosystem and all the Debian ecosystem. And that's nice, because now with RPM, it's a bit, apparently RPM in Fedora has been split in sub-libraries elsewhere, and so you get odd results. Oh, let's see if who's got the package. Because Debian has RPM. But do anybody else have the package? It wasn't so slow. Oh, yes. Interesting. OK. So with this, you can do cross-pollination across distributions. The idea is Debian has screenshots, while the others don't. Then let's use this so that the other people can get screenshots. Or Debian has tags, and the others don't. With this, I can export dev tags for other distributions. And then I can contribute as well, and then I can re-import tags from them. It is exciting. It's kind of just been built, but I'll talk more about the project where this came from, because it is very interesting. And that allows you to build web cross-distribution web services. If you build any like website where people do like rating of software, well, you can use that to export all the ratings you have to whatever distribution, or to get contributions from whatever distribution. There's also OCS. Wait, I know it exists, but I never used it or tried much about it. But it's an RESTful protocol for ratings, comments, and social features like that. And the idea is that you can have any sort of package manager talk OCS with some server that the distribution provides, and that can be used for submitting ratings or downloading ratings about packages. The protocol is there, and it allows more than ratings. Friends, like Facebook inside Aptitude, I'm not quite sure, but I think they use it, they were wanting to use it for Maemo, that's all the documentation of the API, there was some demo about it. KDE people may know more than I do about it. Is there some person that knows more about Dota? Is there someone in the audience that knows more than I do about it? We'll go and find the KDE people later. But that seems to be the way to go for the sort of social interaction, socially contributed package information, crowdsourcing, and so on. So, going back to our example mockups, that example of the search engine kind of application, you can use apt-Xapien index for the search feature, and you can use a recommender that you don't know about yet, but just wait half an hour to provide package recommendations. And of course, screenshots Debian.net for screenshots. All the building blocks are there, you just need to put them together. Same for the one about uninstalling packages. Again, apt-Xapien index to search for them. And if you look in varlog popularity contest, if you have popularity contest installed, you have the last batch of information collected by popularity contest, which basically lists every package you have installed and when's the last time you used it. And you can use that as a data file for yourself to sort packages by last use time. You need to have the file system mounted A time or rel A time. If you mount /usr no A time, that won't work. But if you use rel A time, that allows you to say, show me the packages I don't use, I'll get rid of them. It's there. In terms of the sort of fancy app market thing, again, apt-Xapien index allows to search packages, you get screenshots. App install data will give you icons. Those icons are just taken from app install data. And you can have a look at OCS and see if it works to provide ratings and comments. I think Ubuntu is a bit ahead in looking about it, but I don't know if they built anything. But you can get in touch with Michael Vogt, and he may be able to tell you something more, or the KDE people upstairs. And then this one, you just need to take it over from me and make it beautiful. And it uses apt-Xapien index for searching packages. Apt-Xapien index contains step tags and can already give you tag suggestions and all sort of information. And so this comes out of Xapien basically for free. And again, screenshots Debian.net for screenshots. Can make a, that's a web app I made, and yeah, sure, take it, use it. And again, the browser for what is installed. It's again aptX Appian Index for search. Am I liking aptX Appian Index a lot? But it is really the thing for this kind of quick search. We need to implement last installed information in aptX Appian Index. The information about when a package was last installed is not there yet, but we know how to implement it. There is already a hook in the package, and anybody that's interested talks with me, and I'll show them how to add the plugin to aptX Appian Index, how to hook into the package, and how to put the two things together. I haven't had the time. If somebody else would like to do it, yay. And again, OCS for sending ratings and comments. And if you want to implement list man pages, documentation, and so on, you just have a look at varlib, the package info, and it will tell you the list of files per package, and you just look for the interesting ones, and you show them in a nice way. So, I talked about distro match and cross-distribution collaboration. That came out of the Upstream project, which was a meeting that we had in January in Nuremberg at the OpenSUSE Novell headquarters in Germany. And that's a bunch of people. From basically most major distributions, I think some couldn't come, but they have been invited, and it was unfortunate they couldn't come, but we had Debian and Red Hat Fedora ecosystems were represented, larger ecosystems, so we had Debian and Ubuntu, and we had Fedora, Red Hat, OpenSUSE, and Mageia, which is the new name for Mandriva, and some other things I kind of lost track, were there. Unfortunately, the Gentoo and Arch Linux couldn't come, which was a shame. And the idea was to write some software together to do a kind of modern application installer. And what we came out was, after a couple of days, we came out with a list of technologies that we kind of agreed to use. And that is hopefully Software Center. I say hopefully because the Ubuntu copyright assignment policy is severely screwing up this process, because an employee of Novell or Red Hat cannot justify that they contribute code to, not to free software, but to Canonical in their paid time. So that complicated things a lot, and unfortunately stalled the project. I hope that can be resolved eventually, but I'm not sure what will happen so far. That's an example of copyright assignments impacting cooperation in the free software world. But something like hopefully having Software Center on the client side, possibly PackageKit would be a nice thing to have once it gets fixed a bit, and XAppian database, the aptX Appian Index, basically to have the back end for advanced search functionality, and to have some extra data in the mirrors, like icons, package popularities, and so on, that can be indexed by XAppian. The aptX Appian Index does not only index the usual packages information. It can do all sorts of numbers. Again, like popularity, it can index extra information that's not in the packages file. So it's the ideal place to put all the extra kind of information. Hopefully, then use OCS for rating and comments, and well, that's like when, well, they call it repo compose, I think, some someone not from the Debian ecosystem wrote this, but basically when you build the archive, you extract the extra information that you can download into the application installer. So that kind of outlines technologies that we all decided to use. There's no point in building another backend index for package information. Aptics Appian Index is there. Distributions are now aware of it. And the same about OCS. There's no point building a new protocol for getting package ratings. There is one, which is a simple RESTful protocol. Let's use it. And the wiki of Upstream, there should be the link in my notes in Gobi, has all sort of information about kind of the decisions that have been taken at the meeting. And that is exciting. It was exciting. It just needs, again, people to put energy into it. To me, the important thing that this means is that if you start to do any work in cool package interfaces, you know what technology you should use. You don't have to go around and spend a day looking for, has anyone done this? That's all the starting points that that you need for your work. And you just start there. And people know about it. Other people will be happy to build on your work. So it's there. Use it. Make it awesome. That's the idea. There is no excuse. Oops. There is no excuse not to have a very cool, modern anything about packages. There's no point in being jealous of what the iPhone and Android have. It's easy to implement. We just need to do it. We just need to spend a couple of afternoons doing a prototype and decide to keep maintaining it, basically. My blog, my notes, me, get in touch if you'd like any directions. It's all there. Any questions?
How do you do this distro match thing? How can you refresh these files and how this works?
I'm glad you asked. I basically the input to the system is a list of source to binary package mapping and a list of files in each package for each distribution. And then the idea of distro match is to implement one glue for all sort of methods. It just runs them one after the other. So there's no particularly bleeding edge research on computer machine learning behind it. The point is to have one place where if anyone does it, can be plugged. But at the moment, it looks for .desktop files as sort of markers, because they usually come from Upstream. So if you have two packages that contain the same desktop file in the same path, they're likely the same. And that's kind of considered an exact match. Obviously, if two packages have the same name, then yeah. It looks at the similarity. It looks at key files contained, like if two packages have the same .pm Perl module or .py Python module, then they're obviously the same development. And if they have the same man pages, the same binaries in user bin, and if all of that fails, it will look at general similarity between list of files in the packages. So it kind of keeps going and going. And the interesting thing is that it's done in a way that it builds one index per distribution, and you can go from A to B by sort of getting info out of one and feeding it to the other to get it out.
So you basically parse the RPM and the DEB packages and make this index.
Yeah, the index is built by taking On the Debian side, I query the information out of UDD, and that gets you the whole Deb ecosystem. So derivative distributions, yes, no problem. So we can have Ubuntu, different versions, it's all there. The RPM world has something similar called Sophie, which allows you to find search packages by contents. And they've been kind enough to give me a login on the Sophie server so I could build an export procedure for all the RPM world information, which is vast, and get it out and index it. That was a fantastic example of cross-distro cooperation. There's a machine of the Mageia people, actually, they are running Sophie, that every night contacts the Debian machine via SSH and sends data over.
That's great. I have a similar, but probably more easy questions is up install data where you get all the desktop file and I can. Yes. Oh, it is generated automatically or how does
it's generated automatically. I do not know the details. I don't know if it's DAC doing it. Okay. Anybody knows? Manual? Right, oh, okay.
I think it's manual. Someone needs to upload it. Process all the devs and then upload the result.
Okay, sorry. Then it's not automatic.
If somebody searches for, let's say, Excel, would it be possible to print out alternatives to that?
I'm glad you asked. It works perfectly. Well, you also need to say that you want a program instead of... there's no LibreOffice because nobody tagged it yet. But basic... They're numeric, yeah. But we need to... No, well, LibreOffice is tagged, but I haven't approved the new tags in the distribution yet, I think, because I'm a bit behind with that. But basically, the way this works in apt-x Appian Index, we have Excel as an alias for the depth-x for spreadsheet. And we can do the same, we've done the same for Word and so on. Where is it? And Xapien supports aliases and synonyms, and so we just feed that list, and we can feed more.
So I noticed in your screenshots you seem to be using package names instead of app names, which are quite
different. You mean the distro match?
No, in the screenshots before from your blog post.
Package names.
Yeah, so I think users will probably be more interested in app names rather than as they appear in the menu, rather than package names, because that's kind of a technical detail that they don't necessarily need to know about.
True, but on the other hand, we are talking about... unless they have something about app names, and I don't know, but we are talking about something that you use... that you use in a package manager. And in a package manager, you work with packages. And you can actually map from packages to apps. But then in that mapping, you can do the inverse mapping and get screenshots. I forgot, talking about custom interfaces for different users. Oh, I have a new laptop, and I don't have it installed. There's one that's called GoPlay, which will be installed in 3 seconds, two, one. 0. Which does that? It go play, look for a game. So you can see games already installed or that are not installed or both, and you can choose the kind of game, and you can choose the interface, and there you go, a list of three-dimensional arcade games with screenshots and descriptions and tags and so on. It does everything except install it. Sorry. But it's an interesting example about sort of per-task interfaces that is way more simple than any other package manager, and it's only for games. And you want to say like Doom, and it's very quick, and you get them, and then the categories automatically change. Interactive Doom. Oh yeah, it's probably mentioned Doom in the description. And interestingly, just by changing the dev tags, tags that are used, there's Go Admin with system administration, so clustering, system boot, benchmarking, and so on, and the interface, and fast search, and list of packages. Not many screenshots for sysadmin packages. But if I filter for three-dimensional sysadmin packages, maybe, and we do have 3D sysadmin packages. There's Go Safe for security things, antivirus authentication, forensics, three-dimensional. Okay, same thing. again, more example of things that is not hard to do. That also, guess what, uses up Xapin Index. And in terms of mapping applications to packages, this is an application installer, a prototype application installer we built. And you just type, I don't know, image editor, and you get a list of image editors. That user uses, guess what? Yes, indeed. It looks for packages, but shows apps. So only those that have desktop files. And it just tells up Xapin Index, only give me those packages that contain desktop files. And there you have it. And so you get fast search on everything using the package descriptions that are more verbose than the description in the desktop files. On the other hand, it merges desktop file descriptions into the keywords, so it actually searches on both. Yeah, it was an example that's quite nice. Actually, I need to show you this other feature, which is very intriguing. Although, can I have home? And okay, it's a photo, it's an image. I drag it here, and I get packages that can open image. And then I can just open it in NetSurf. It took, 2 hours to do the sort of drag and show icon thing? It really is, now it's all easy to do. It just needs ideas and throw some code at it. Do it. I'm busy with the plumbing. I would like to do it, but I don't have the time. So I want people to do it. Do it.
And going back to the Xapin Index,
yes,
I was also playing at the same time as you, and I saw that the example you did,
yes,
that it was showing, I don't know what you were looking for, but it showed first the libraries, and you were looking,
yes,
for Excel.
Mm-hmm.
So is that on purpose, is a bug or what? Because I'm thinking that as a user, I would not like to see the libraries first.
Of course. With
100%
as a user,
points.
As a user, you do not want Axie cache. you'd expect if you want programs to have like a GUI or something that can show you screenshots.
But why the library?
If you want, you just say that you want role program. Search. And then no libraries.
Mm-hmm. In any case, it was a little weird to see that the library was more relevant than numeric.
Oh, for the Office?
For the Excel example.
Relevant, well, because of the description, really looked like screenshotty. Now, I added a role program to it, and excellent bifurcation. right? Okay. We can work on that. It's an excellent game, but... well, yes, you know, it matches the package name exactly, and maybe inside it just says Excel, and so, but then in an ideal interface, you get this, and you say, what the hell is excellent bifurcation? I want spreadsheet, and you just filter, I want spreadsheet. And you would click on it, and then you can build a tag cloud. That's a tag cloud. This is a text mode tag cloud. And, you know, there, for free. Done. There's an example called My Blog in Python. As you type. It's fast enough that you type and you get a tag cloud out.
Hey, yeah? Do you have any example of web interface using these things?
Of a?
Web interface?
Yes, package that... No slides. This prototype I made, I don't dare starting it because it probably would blow up. Since I haven't started it in the last 6 months, and you know code will unwrite itself as you don't use it. But this works, and it again you can search. It will. I implemented filters like only desktop applications, only programming libraries, and so on, that you can choose in there. And by default, it will only show you desktop applications. And then you can shop by tags. On my blog. Commented with descriptions and everything.
So I think we need to finish. Thank you, Enrico, very much for this inspiring talk. And I hope you got somebody who throws code on your ideas.
Hope so too. Thank you.